Please stand. We'll begin today's celebration with number 208, Praise to the Lord, number 208.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Your Eminence, Cardinal Gregory, as the pastor here at St. Nicholas, and on behalf of the majority, I think it's fair to say, of our congregation tonight from St. Nicholas, I welcome you back, and I am honored that you chose St. Nicholas as the location for this region's Mass of Thanksgiving for those that we honor for their generosity and support for the Church of Washington. Your Excellency Bishop Campbell, it's my first opportunity as pastor to welcome you back to St. Nicholas and your parishioners from St. Joseph's in Largo. We also welcome back Father Jeff Samaha, the hardworking and never harder than these days chaplain for the Southern Maryland Hospital Center. Our Deacon Eric Samantis could have a staff meeting, I think, with those who've joined us today from the offices of the Archdiocese. Welcome to all of you, and thanks for working with us to tackle the logistics for this Mass and the reception to follow. And welcome to those who have joined us from St. Mary of the Mills in Laurel, St. Matthias in Lanham, St. John Baptist de La Salle in Chilham, St. Columba in Oxon Hill, St. Mary of the Assumption in Upper Marlboro, St. Pius X in Bowie, St. Hugh's in Greenbelt, Holy Family in Mitchellville, Holy Redeemer in College Park, and the Nigerian community in Hyattsville. If I missed anyone, I'm sure you'll let me know at the reception, and I ask your forgiveness in advance. Welcome to all of you.
Father Tim, thank you very much for that very inclusive list of people and communities that are gathered here. We come together as one family. Our hearts are filled with joy as we are beginning to exit our pandemic. And I am so grateful that St. Nicholas agreed to host this Mass of Thanksgiving. We come together as the people of God. We are beloved by the Father as we ask for his merciful forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Never allow the gates of hell to prevail against your church, firmly founded on the apostolic rock. Grant her, we pray, that through the intercession of Pope Saint Leo, she may stand firm in your truth and know the protection of lasting peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Hear, O kings, and understand. Learn, you magistrates of the earth's expanse. Hearken, you who are in power over the multitude and lord it over throngs of peoples. Because authority was given to you by the Lord and sovereignty by the Most High, who shall probe your works and scrutinize your counsels. Because though you were ministers of his kingdom, you judged not rightly and did not keep the law, nor walk according to the will of God. Terribly and swiftly he shall come against you, because judgment is stern for the exalted. For the lowly may be pardoned out of mercy, but the mighty shall be mightily put to the test. For the Lord of all shows no partiality, nor does he fear greatness, because he himself made the great as well as the small, and he provides for all alike. But for those in power, a rigorous scrutiny impends. To you, therefore, O princes, are my words addressed, that you may learn wisdom and you may not sin. For those who keep the holy precepts hallowed shall be found holy, and those learned in them will have ready a response. Desire therefore my words, long for them, and you shall be instructed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Rise up, O God, bring judgment to the earth. Rise up, O God, bring judgment to the earth. Defend the lowly and the fatherless. Render justice to the afflicted and the destitute. Rescue the lowly and the from the hand of the wicked, deliver them. Rise up, O God, bring judgment to the earth. rise up, O God, bring judgment to the earth.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus continued his journey to Jerusalem, he traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering a village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voice, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priest." As they were going, they were cleansed, and one of them, realizing that he had been healed, returned, glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, 10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Occasionally, the readings from the Word of God fit so perfectly on a particular occasion that some might say they were planted. But in today's gospel, we find absolutely the best description of why we gather, why I've visited here at St. Nicholas, and I don't think I could find a better gospel to share with you, because it is a gospel that recognizes in that one individual that we ought to be grateful for what we receive. So many of us, myself included, spend so much time thinking about what we don't have that we fail to give thanks for that which we do have. In the past, at this time of year, the Archbishop of Washington would host one or two events at the cathedral in which he invited folks who had been very supportive of the annual appeal to come and have Mass with him and allow him to say a word of gratitude. But the pandemic changed those dynamics because we weren't able, as you well know, to gather in very large numbers. And so I recommended to our development office that rather than have a lot of people travel to the cathedral, why doesn't the Archbishop travel to them? With the same message that was extended in the cathedral, a word of gratitude. Gratitude to you for your support for the annual appeal. But I want to begin this evening by thanking you for your support for your parishes. In truth, the appeal is an important venture that we do together, but your generosity to your parishes allows these communities, wherever they may be, to continue the mission of the church. So I am most grateful, And I know that Father Tim and Bishop Roy would say, you tell them, Cardinal. I'm most grateful that you are so supportive to our local communities, to the parishes and to the works of charity that the parishes provide, not only in their own community, but the pandemic has made it aware, made us aware that an awful lot of people depend on the charitable outreach of our local communities. I was amazed, and maybe you were too, to know how many food pantries were established during the pandemic, because people throughout this archdiocese, and we are a blessed community, but many people found it necessary to turn to some of those food pantries to assist them in moments when they didn't quite have enough. And it was the generosity of our people that both expanded existing food pantries and then enlarged others or established food pantries. So thank you, first of all, for your support of the local communities that make this such a blessed archdiocese. But then I am also grateful that your generosity extends beyond your parish to the annual appeal, because in that effort, all of us pool our resources together to respond in ways that would not be possible for individual communities to do. But if we come together, we can do some wondrous things, supporting Catholic charities and the education of our priests and school communities. They benefit from your generosity. So, like the Samaritan in today's gospel, I want to remember to come and thank you. So now that this is a new tradition, and you know, it doesn't take long for Catholics to lock into a tradition. We've done it now 2 years, and I don't think we're ever going to go back. Well, I will have a Mass at the cathedral, but I find it much more appropriate that I come out to the various parishes that host these gatherings to say from the heart, thank you. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for your dedication to your parishes and to the Archdiocese. Now, the gospel that we just heard of that one Samaritan who discovered that he had been healed, and he went back to Jesus to say thank you. You may hear that same gospel on Thanksgiving, because it is so appropriate, and it's such a wonderful reminder that all of us have been given so many gifts, so many blessings, and an invitation for us to say thanks and to deepen our gratitude for all that God has given us by sharing from our bounty to those that are in need. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, I have to say to Father Tim, this is my third visit to St. Nicholas. Now, if you're from parishes that I haven't gotten to yet, it's not that I love St. Nicholas any more than I love you, and I'll get to all the other parishes as soon as I can, but I did want to single out Father Tim and the parishioners of St. Nicholas for being so consistently hospitable and this evening welcoming so many of their neighbors. Thank you. Because we know that the Father loves us, and he always listens to us when we speak to him in the name of his Son.
For the church, that we may work together to bring Christ our daily bread to all people of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving to the Lord for inspiring the generosity of the donors to our Archdiocesan annual appeal, May the good works which they make possible bear fruit and hasten the fulfillment of the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in vocations to the priesthood, diaconate, and consecrated life, especially in the Archdiocese of Washington, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died in Christ may enter with him into their eternal inheritance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all of the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, fill us with your Spirit as you fill us with your life. Give us breath to praise you to the ends of the earth. Help us to grant forgiveness as you have forgiven our sins, and be with us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we present our gifts, join in singing number 396, Be Thou My Vision, number 396.
Goodness, we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Through the offerings made here, we pray, O Lord, graciously shed light on your church, so that your flock may everywhere prosper, and that under your governance, the shepherds may become pleasing to your name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Leo the Great, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Leo the Great, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Wilton our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Timothy.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Peter said to Jesus, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus replied, "You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church."
Thank you.
Let us pray. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to govern the church which you have nourished by this holy meal, so that firmly directed she may enjoy ever greater freedom and persevere in integrity of religion, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. As a gesture of gratitude, I'd like to bless the rosaries that are being given to you as a sign of the sincere thanks of the Archdiocese and of our parishes for your generosity. We will ask the blessing on these rosaries and pray that the Mother of God will dwell in your homes and in your hearts, especially as we enter this Advent season. I would be remiss were I not also to thank publicly and sincerely my brother Sir Knights, who are here as an honor guard, and to make sure that everything goes well. Let us pray. Gentle and loving Father, we ask your blessing upon these rosaries, this prayer that allows us to honor both you and your son's mother. May those who receive the rosaries know your blessing and know your peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. The archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
We go forth singing number 485, Love Divine, All Loves Excelling. Number 485.
Fix in us.